Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about when you can switch your Essex or Vivera or Clear Retainer to Nights from Days. Now keep in mind, if you're listening to this and you are a consumer, don't listen to what I have to say. You need to talk to, this is good talking points. You need to bring these talking points if you're not sure what's going on to your orthodontist or to your dentist who did your treatment. This is meant for doctors who are learning a little bit more about doing orthodontics in their practice and what I do historically in my practice and how we manage things. Now, number two, this isn't going to make an awful lot of sense unless you've watched all the rest of my retention videos. There's a retention playlist on the homepage of my YouTube channel. If you scroll down, you'll see it. Otherwise, you can search by keyword within my Straight Smile Solutions YouTube channel, Retainer. Make sure you watch all those videos first because I'm going to build on the concepts we already talked about. Number three, if you're like a reading kind of person, we also have blogs. If you go to straightsmilesolutions.com, you go to, I think it's in the About Us category. It's towards the right of the tabs. Open that up. You're going to see blogs. Or you can just Google Straight Smile Solutions blogs. There's a little place, search by keyword. I have over 400 blogs to date, and you can put in Retainer or Essex or anything like that, and all the blogs and content is going to come up. Number four, I also have a really great handout called Retainer Menu, which is like, you can't use it because it has all my branding all over it and it is copyrighted, but you can emulate it. You can create something similar is what I'm getting at. It's just talking points so you understand a little bit more. You need to have a whole retainer policy, a retainer warranty, how you're going to do retainers. And this is something you need to let the patient know before you even start any orthodontic treatment, be it aligners or braces or phase one. They need to know what's included in the retainers so there's no assessing additional fees, there's no bait and switch. I don't always tell them what retainer they're going to get. I let our patients know they're going to get one set of whatever type of retention is recommended. If they choose a different type of retention that's not recommended, there may be an additional fee. Also, I let them know that if they choose or if what's recommended is the clear Essex or Vivera retainer, well, Vivera always comes in sets of four, so that's a non-issue. They're going to need more than one set in a lifetime, and it's strongly recommended that they purchase additional sets at the time of debond. We do offer them the ability to get that Vivera upgrade from a single set of Essex retainers to a Vivera set of four, which is four uppers and four lowers, at cost, no additional fee, just our lab fee, which is what, like $295 or something like that for eight retainers total. It's actually a steal. But even if you don't have an iTero and you aren't able to send to Align Technology, pretty much almost every ortho lab offers sets, and they make really good Essex retainers in sets. Just off the top of my head, I know Specialty Appliances does them. My white label company that I work with, Global, they do them, and it's probably going to be about the same price as the Vivera, if not possibly even a little bit cheaper. I'm not exactly sure, but I know it's a similar price. So you can still offer those sets. Remember, if you are making in-house Essex retainers, unless you are using the proper tools and equipment to make them, and I have a whole thing on thermoforming. If you go into my channel and look up thermoforming, if you're not using the BioStar, the MiniStar, the Durfomat, something like that, if you're just using a vacuum thing, no. What's going to happen is your patient's going to relapse. It's just not adapting properly. That's meant for temporary. I used those in residency, like, okay, we're sending out for a retainer to the lab. It's going to take 2 weeks to come in. We'll just make a temporary retainer right now. Or maybe we're making a temporary retainer because we're going to do preps, you know, on a tooth, and then we're going to scan for a new one or impress for a new one. But that should never be your permanent long-term retainer. The teeth 100% will relapse. And if they do, you know, your patient has a right to make a complaint because you didn't use proper equipment. You were trying to cheap out in terms of making in-house. Don't make four sets of that because they're just going to relapse. It just doesn't hold the same as a pressure forming vacuum retainer, which is a BioStar, a MiniStar, or a Durfomat. And I'm not the techie person, so I do have some content about it. But if you want to invest in that kind of stuff, you should definitely, there's definitely some people I can send you to who can advise you and consult you on that. Not really my jam. So I'm a send out lab person. So I do not enjoy lab work at all. But yeah, don't try to do it in-house unless it's for temporary measures, unless you have the right equipment to do it, which includes a high quality 3D printer. And those are not the $5,000 ones, okay? And the MiniStar, BioStar, Durfomat is gonna be $10,000-$15,000, something like that. Otherwise, you send out. Just use those for the temporary. Okay, so I put all that aside. Now let's talk about when can you switch? And the answer is, can't tell you. You know, it's different in every single patient. Basically, I put all my patients on, okay, again, you never use Essex retainers or Vivera retainers unless your bite is settled. That means you've checked with articulating paper, bite, bite, tap, tap, and you have solid posterior contacts on all posterior teeth, canine, premolars, first molar, second molar. I don't care about the third molars. So if they're erupted and if they have an opposing. If you don't have that, you should not be putting an Essex or a clear retainer in. You are locking the patient into a bad, bad, bad bite. If you're a consumer and you want to know if this is the case, you can buy articulating paper at Amazon for a dollar or two. It's really cheap, eBay. You can check it yourself. I don't want to stir up stuff, but I'm just letting you know it's really easy to bite, bite, tap, tap, and check. So if you don't have the solid contacts, then you need to do a refinement, or you need to do step down bends, or you need to do rebracketing in braces, or you need to do settling elastics. Not always the most predictable. Or you can place bonded upper and lower retainers and let the bite settle. That's only if you don't have anterior contacts, you can do that. I have a ton of videos on posterior open bite with braces, posterior open bite with aligners. You can look at those, they're in my channel. So assuming all of this is done properly and you're good to go and you have great contacts and you can go straight into the Essex or Vivera, I usually have my patients wear them full time for 3 months. Now remember, my patients aren't getting one set. It's pretty much required that they're gonna upgrade to more sets. They're gonna run through that first set in just a few months. They're gonna start to warp, they're gonna stretch out. It's not necessarily something that you can see, and every single patient is different, okay? So there's gonna be one patient that's gonna stretch them out in 4 weeks. There's one that might take 6 months, and it's not really something I can see. So that's why I want them switching. Follow the guidance from Vivera. If you look at Vivera instructions, they say to wear the first set for 3 months full time, then throw it away and start the second set at nights. That's pretty much what I agree with. That's just playing it safe, you know, and obviously if it gets a crack or a hole or a break or something like that, you're gonna have to switch it out sooner, but no more than 3 months. So this is again where you need to have that retainer warranty in the policy before they even start ortho. They need to understand you're gonna get one set, but we pretty much strongly require for you to purchase additional sets. Otherwise, we cannot guarantee your outcome. And that's what it comes down to. You wanna have a warranty process, not only for the retainers, but also for the shifting. I always strongly recommend that you take photos with the retainers in to show that they fit. This is key. You need to do this, because I can't tell you how many times when I didn't do this, and it was he said, she said, my word, did I finish it? I might have final photos, but then they'll be like, well, the retainers didn't fit. Well, if you have another set of photos with the retainers in showing they fit, that pretty much just ends that issue. Well, yes, they did. Look, I have a picture of it. Because properly fitting retainers, teeth stay straight, as long as you're switching them out on a regular basis, and they're actually being worn. And the beauty is, even if you oopsied and you forgot them for a few days and put them back in, usually it straightens the teeth back again, assuming they were properly fitting from the beginning. So again, I don't want to cause trouble here with this video, but that's the truth. So that's why you take a full set of final records, final pano, as well as a set of final records with the final retainers in, showing that they are fitting. You also have the patient sign a statement of satisfaction, saying that they're happy with the outcome and that the retainers fit, and they understand that, you know, the warranty is X, Y, and Z. Usually I'll warranty retainers on breakage or anything like that, not loss. This is not a Shurion, you know, for your phone, but you know, on breakage, I mean, obvious breakage, if it's obviously crushed, that's a different story, but you know, like it tears or something like that, for 30 days, you know, something reasonable. Beyond that, there's an additional fee for any type of breakage. I do give the opportunity for the patient to buy multiple sets at Debond at cost, no additional fee. Anytime after that, it's gonna be an additional cost. You make sure you write it down on the paper so they know what the additional cost is gonna be per set or per retainer, so that they're aware and they sign it. If you do not do all this, I can 100% guarantee you there's gonna be issues that will come up, because people have selective memory, they're gonna get angry. It's an amazing way to get just terrible complaints, you know, and complaints to dental boards, insurance companies, reviews on your site. If you just have this all in writing and have the proper records, which only literally takes you a few minutes, it will eliminate all that hassle. I got a terrible Yelp review once because like a retainer wasn't ready on time, which wasn't even my fault. And I was like out of town, and I got the message from the lab that it was delayed. I called the front desk. I told them to call the patient. They didn't. Patient showed up, blasted me on Yelp, you know, and it stayed up there for 10 years. It's finally gone, thank goodness. I was like, that wasn't even my fault. You know, I'm sorry. But you know, when it comes to retainers, getting braces off, getting aligners done, shifting, relapse, I mean, moms and dads get angry. So just be prepared. I still haven't fully answered your question, but normally I'll switch after tonight's, after 3 months of full-time wear. But then the it's going from the every night to the every other night, to the every third night, to the once a week, to the twice a month. That's where, listen, I'm gonna offer 1 year's worth of retainer visits at no cost. It's up to you guys. A lot of you guys who are GPs, you should definitely put that also in your contract, what you're gonna offer. A lot of people, there's so many cool and creative ways you can put them on a subscription program where maybe they're only billing $49 a year or something like that, and something really reasonable as auto bill. And when they come to, maybe 99 is better. And whenever they come to their 6 month visit, they have a, they have the option to get a fresh set of retainers, you know, at, you know, a really reasonable cost, like, you know, $10 or something like that. Or, you know, or you can automatically give it to them and have them waiting. That's another option. That's a really nice way to get the patients in to your recall visit, and it incentivizes them to make sure they come in regularly, but you let them know that, you know, or maybe once a year, that they have to make it to the visit. You know, they can't just, they don't just get it for not coming. It's only for regular recall patients. That's a super cool way, and it gets great passive income just coming in. They may or may not even use, you know, so you can do that. The way that I like to tell patients, you know, after that 1 year I've been seeing them, usually I see them at a 1 month recall, then a 3 month recall, then a 6 month recall. So three retainer visits, that's usually what I've always done. It's within a year afterwards. After that, retainer visits are usually, I mean, it kind of depends. If they started other siblings or something, usually I'll do it at no cost. But if not, you know, there's going to be a small fee for a retainer check or adjustment. But I mean, for the most part, with an Essex retainer, there's nothing to adjust. So if something's not fitting, it's a matter of just sticking it back in again, or making a new one, or doing alignment again if it's not fitting. So there's nothing really to adjust. In terms of how that they phase it down, it's different from patient to patient. I like to tell the patients at that, once we've gotten to, so first month retainer visit, they're still on full time. Then I tell them they can go to nights after 3 months. So I'm going to see them at the 4 month check. By then they should be at nights. I say, how does it feel? How does it feel when you put them in at night, you know, at that point? Does it feel tight after you've had them all the day? Does it not feel tight? I tell them if it feels at all tight or achy, then you need to stay where you are, just still wearing them every single night. Not time to go every other night yet, until it no longer feels tight or achy at all, because that's the sign the teeth are moving. Then we're going to go to every other night once they feel comfortable with that. And, you know, maybe by the 6 month, you know, 10 months after they're off, 6 month additional, 1 month, 3 month, 6 month is 10 months. They should definitely be either all nights or every other night, you know, it's kind of where they are. And then that's the last appointment. And I tell them, okay, well, you know, you can slowly phase down to one night a week. But of course, if they feel tight or achy, you need to be wearing them more. You basically need to decide what you need. I offer them the opportunity at that point to get additional retainers at a discounted rate. You know, highly recommend they have a few backups. You can even put some in your storage lockbox at the bank. I mean, you want it someplace cool, not hot, not sweaty, not humid, where you can safely tuck them away just in case you lose them, and where someone else can have access to them. I know some people that left some at grandma's house in their sock drawer. They have them all over the place. You want to have lots. And this is also where it's a really great idea to store that STL in the cloud. There's different places where you can store it. I actually have some videos on cloud retaining STL files. I believe Invisalign, if you do Vivera, they hold them for 7 years. That is my understanding. They have not confirmed that. But beyond that, you're going to have to find other places to hold those STLs, because they don't stay indefinitely in your scanner. There are banks. I mentioned a few in some other videos, so you can look that up. That's a really smart thing to do. Or you can, the other thing you can do is you can even print out a model, you know, and give it to the patient and let them hold it. You know, a physical model. It doesn't have to be an STL. And say, hey, if there's any issue, bring this back. I'll make you another retainer. And then it's on them to hold it. A lot of people do that too. I'm not going to physically hold physical models. You know what I mean? It's going to only be cloud. So if you do all that, there really shouldn't be any relapse, as long as your patient doesn't ghost for a long period of time. And if they do, then it's going to be a new case. So hopefully that was helpful. Thanks.